Stripling or Brass Knuckles and the My Little Pony fandom, and this is Flippy.
Hi, Flippy. Hello. This is my first panel.
We're actually going to talk about that, dude.
Yeah.
So this is Achievement Unlocked, Goal Setting, and Furthermore Edition. Yeah. You can do it! So we're here to talk about goal setting. What do you have, and what does it need? Commitment should probably actually have a bullet in front of it, but that's okay.
Whoops.
The fly is not a bullet.
your bullet point flew away.
I know!
The patience, oh my gosh, patience.
Patience.
Mainly with yourself, too. In my regards. Oh. Go understanding.
Mm-hmm.
You can't just be like, I'm going to do this. You have to understand what you want to do and things you need to do to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And then effort, I guess that also goes in with patience, it's also about being persistent. Let's kind of go together. Welcome back.
Thank you.
So, take a seat wherever.
An example of that is, this is a relic from bygone era. How many of you have played The Legend of Zelda on the original Nintendo? I knew I had my kindred spirits here. When I was 8 years old, I made this map of the entire game. It has all of the dungeon locations, where the groupies are, where the bad guys are, where the hearts are.
What items are in each?
What items, the secret codes to get through some of the levels we had to do up sideways. This map had it all.
Whoa.
My sisters and I made this while we played the whole game, because there was no internet back in those days. And at the same time,
it's really cool.
It's fantastic.
What is that map?
The Legend of Zelda.
I should know that.
I made that when I was 8 years old.
My sister and I did that with Willow.
You had to, right? There was no internet. We were too poor.
You didn't just memorize Willow?
So was for a movie, that would have been easy.
I tried the originals of the
We also didn't have enough money to afford Nintendo Power. We were lucky to have Nintendo, much less to get a subscription to magazines. So we had to spend the time, and instead of dying and keep going and dying and keep going, by making the map, we were able to progress through the entire game. We beat it, and then we started over again because when you named your character Zelda, you got to the special second level.
It was a secret mission of the game that you should do maps.
Yeah, so that was how we did goal setting very young, very video game oriented, but it helped us to beat it. Co-op. Our parents probably were so happy that we were like creatively keeping ourselves tied to our Nintendo. We had a separate TV and everything. So that was an example of how, even at a young age, you can use goal setting step by step, stage by stage, to record your progress and how you got there. And you also have an example.
Oh, you'll see why in the next slide.
Okay.
So I hope some of you recognize who this person is. Oh. We just went over
yes.
It. Totally doable. Just takes time.
Takes time.
So much time. Speaking of time.
Yeah.
Has anyone played any Fire Emblem?
Oh.
I don't know. Whatever. That money and all stuff. Basically, there's 40 characters in that game you can get. I spent hours just writing notes I have in my wallet of how I want to build each character for every map, because it's a strategy game too. It's actually about ground rules, just so you know. Feel free to read a little tidbit from Tumblr.
Has anyone else ever gotten stuck in those time quests? Right?
Side quests, yay!
I would much rather be gathering herbs and meat than actually fighting bad guys.
Sure.
But sometimes you have to...
Depends on the quest, I suppose.
Yeah.
Or you get distracted by them very easily.
Right.
Like, this is easier. I want to do this. I'm going to do this for a while. Oh, I should be doing that. Oh, well, whatever.
Actually, I get distracted by side quests because I'm a completionist.
Yes.
That too.
And that takes patience.
Believe it or not, I had like 4 different save files on Skyrim.
Yes.
One for a Jack of all trades, one for a warrior, one for a thief and assassin, one for a mage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And
more mage.
Huh?
I'm playing more mage.
Oh, nice. And average of about 500 hours each.
Wow.
Yeah, that's impressive.
Like, I want to do all the quests. I'm gonna make my characters in a way that they look over everything. But anyway.
So why is it that we spend so much time on video games, but yet it's really difficult to get a job because we don't invest 500 hours into writing resumes. Like, that doesn't sound as fun, right? It's, games make it so that you can understand how to achieve your goals, and then we have to turn that into real life, which is what this panel is all about. So, ground rules. We are here to help you, but it's not like you can do it because it's hard.
We want to give you a few tools
yeah.
that we use that work for us.
I hope they help you though.
Yeah.
Yeah. Number two. He's more professional at this than I am. But we are here just to give advice, but if you want real help, like seek help from whether it's financial advisors, counselors.
Yeah, I just have BS psychology, the BS computer.
There are no bad ideas, no bad questions. Friendship.
Woo! Friendship is magic.
Hell yeah. No, that's not saying that.
Well.
And no bullying, no teasing, we're all here to learn.
I'm okay with teasing, fine.
And please ask questions as we go along.
Interrupt us.
We expect this panel to be about an hour long. We can go longer or shorter depending on your needs.
And if they kick us out or not.
Yes. So, let's go to the first example.
Awesome.
This is me about 10 years ago. And I made this costume from Gaia Online. It was a little avatar chat room forum-y kind of thing. Like,
I
it was,
remember Gaia Online. Jeez, that's been, it's been so long.
I know. I did so Neopets for a while, and this was like the next stage.
Gosh,
Neopets was a long fork.
I feel sorry for my Neopets.
I know. They're like so hungry now.
I forgot the, I love the information.
Don't worry, they're all vacation.
Oh,
no,
Mr.
God.
Mr.
God. Gaia Online. Thankfully, you didn't need to feed those avatars. And I decided to dress up as Moira, the shopkeeper. She's pretty cool. This was pre-second gen avatar, so nobody knew much about her, but I thought she was cute. And she kind of matched my style. So I made this for Otakon 2006. Kind of shows my age in cosplay years. And I got the patterns, I got the fabric. Cosplaying is hard work. You've got to make sure you have everything in line, that you have all the materials, and then you have to sew it. Much like you have to do with fursuits, you have to spend a lot of time actually building it. And you always underestimate how long it'll take, right?
Yep.
So I got the pants done, I had a top, and then I was working on the jacket, and it was the day before Otakon. And how many of you have worked on cosplay the day before? Okay. Whether it's a lot or a little, it's not healthy. I can tell you this because as I was sewing, it was about 11 at night, I was just like, oh my God, I gotta get this done. I was working on the collar, so it's like almost done. And then I feel this really, really sharp pain in my finger. And I look down and it's literally impaled by the sewing needle.
Oh no.
And I'm like, well, should I take my finger out of the needle or just leave it there? I didn't know, I was so delirious. Thankfully, it was a side puncture. It didn't hit the bone or any major veins, and so I was able to take it off and wrap it up, and I think it's, you can see the bandage in the photo.
It's hard to see, but it's there.
I should not have done that. Why do we do things at the last minute? Because it leads to these possible accidents. It also leads to lack of sleep, which can make you sick, which some people, you know, they can get tired or faint or get sick. Con crud. Your immunity goes down the less sleep you have.
Yep.
So you should get things done early, but it's really hard to do it early instead of the last minute. Procrastination is bad, but that's what we always end up doing.
Yep.
Yeah. So that's an example of what not to do. It looked beautiful in the end, but I was not happy about having my hand taped up all weekend. Yeah. So that's that. So what's the difference? Why do we put things off? There's two ways of thinking about it. Prioritization.
Mm-hmm.
I can't means that you are choosing not to do something. I can't means you cannot, which means that you cannot physically do it. So if you say, I can't make this costume, it means maybe you don't know how to sew,
mm-hmm.
or you don't have the materials. If you say, I won't do it this week, and you'd rather go out to play games, or maybe you have family that you have to go to dinner with, you say, I won't be able to do it. I won't means that you're choosing to put something else first. So if you build the slide, it's all about prioritization. what do you put first, what do you choose to do or what do you choose not to do, and how do we change that a lot of times. I can say that for me, if I am doing something and a friend asks me to help them, I will stop what I'm doing to help my friends. That's a priority for me. But that also means that if I'm working on my costume and a friend asks me to help with theirs, mine is now not a priority because I value my friendship in that way. It's the same at work. If I am in my corporate job and I'm working on some stupid project, and you know you never like getting projects done at the last minute too, and somebody calls me up and says, hey, can you help me with this? I'm like, of course, yeah, I'm right on. But if your boss comes in and says, why are you not doing the project and why are you helping someone else, you can get in trouble sometimes. So prioritization can cause good and bad, and that's something you can choose. You can choose what to do. Next.
Don't play the video game or do homework.
So we recommend that you make your own deadlines. And if you build it, you have to think of something realistic. Should you be able to make an entire costume in 2 or 3 days? Should you be
it depends on the costume, but it's still not recommended.
If you build it, how many of you have worked on group projects? And how much time do those take? Get it over with sooner than later. Yeah. And next?
Yeah.
That's him.
That's me. I never did. Like, you know what? At this point, I'm done. Either do it or don't. Okay, this is a fun one. All right, I'm going to be wordy. So the psychology behind it, so your brain is weird. Building upon, someone said something earlier, let me think about this. So my brain is crazy. So a lot of studies have been done showing that the brain actually, it explains a lot. You're more likely to do procrastination because I have my food, I sleep, I eat or drink, okay, now I just do whatever I want instead of like fun goals like I'm going to build a fursuit or I'm going to have a cosplay with it. The thing about setting goals down ahead of time, like planning for goals ahead of time, is you can trick yourself into them all being little short deadline, little small tasks that you're totally okay doing them the next day in order to get yourself to do them. Like they've done studies, like breaking down, like versus I'm gonna get this done in 1 month versus I'm gonna do this part this day, this part this day, this part this day. They've shown studies that not only does it trick yourself into getting it done, it tricks yourself into being motivated to do it, which is a big thing.
So again, going back to the Zelda map, right? We did this literally in The Legend of Zelda. We did this every scroll by scroll, every page we wrote down something. You couldn't say, I'm going to make the entire map of the Zelda game. You have to go level by level.
Yeah, and also it helps not feel overwhelmed. Mm-hmm. Like last minute overwhelmed is not good and puncture your finger or something.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. One fun thing to do, that like an example of a really fun thing to do to trick yourself into getting things done, we're going to go on like how we do lists. What I would do every morning, like in college or something, is I'd write down a list, set my clothes out, and put the list on top of my clothes. So it's like, I have to physically touch this list and move it, and I'll see everything to remind myself to do it first thing in the morning.
Tricky.
I do little tricks like that with my alarm clock.
Yeah, like you write down a list, put it on your pants, because not you're writing it down, so you do it before you go to sleep, so it's on your brain.
Yeah.
And then you get up and say it's like, oh, that's right, okay. Easily go to the pocket.
So how do you make these goals?
An example of a way to do it.
Make it smart by doing specific goals that you can measure how much you get done, that you know you can do, that are realistic, and that are within a certain amount of time. Flippy, you have an example about NaNoWriMo.
Oh yeah, so like say NaNoWriMo, you're the one that actually did it. I haven't done it yet.
Writing novels in November. 50,000 words in 1 month.
Yep. Like for examples, like instead of just saying I'm gonna do 50,000 words by this month, like say I'm gonna write 10,000 or more words on at least 4 more days this week by before November 7th, for like the first week. So the deadline's there, so you have more motivation to do it.
And you still can miss the deadline, but when you do, you realize how much you missed it by. So if you are supposed to do an average 2,500 words a day, which is about 2 pages, if you don't do it for 3 days, then you go, oh no. And you start to realize how much just a few things that you miss add up, so you have to spend a full day writing to catch up. When if you had done an hour every day, it would be much easier. Okay, so before we go into my case study, are there any questions on what we've gone over so far? Goal setting is hard, and it takes practice, but you have to think about it. So as we go through some examples of how you can help yourself to get through goal setting and making it work for you, that's the important part. You have to find what works for you. You can use the notes on your clothes. You can use alarm reminders. You can use phones, apps. We're going to go through a whole bunch of examples now on how you can get through it. And I want to start by showing you this really cool guy. Anyone play Magic the Gathering?
Yeah.
They got a couple of fans in the back. Card game, fantasy card game, where you've got your monsters and your magic spells, and there's tournaments. Neil Oliver is a champion. He, if you build it once, he played Modern Masters in 2013 in Las Vegas. Very expensive format. 5,000 people he beat out to become the grand champion of the largest tournament to date. And he got a fantastic looking trophy.
Yeah.
I had the honor of giving an hour-long interview to him, and he spoke about how he got to where he is. He's now a full-time streamer on Twitch.tv, playing Magic for a living, and streaming and going to tournaments. You can be jealous of where he is, but you also have to be jealous of his work. He worked hard to get there, and he did that first by figuring out what his dream was. He started playing Magic casually, but then got more and more into it and started practicing. Then he had to plan steps. So once he got into it, you have to make the decision to invest, and then to start playing in tournaments and practicing. And it does take money, so the question is, how do you get the money? And so he would be doing tutoring as a side job to get the money to play. And actually, it's funny because now he's like, I kind of want to go into coaching because I really enjoyed that tutoring time. Mm-hmm. So even though he's gaming as a real life, he's like, I still want to do a real job. It's weird.
Yeah.
But he had to work to get the money to play. And then he practiced so much that he was able to become a champion. And that was because he was very patient and also he was very flexible. So if you build two more times, he says, if you fail, take it as an opportunity to learn. You're never going to win every game. What did you do wrong? Go back and look at the steps. Record yourself. So we are recording this panel. It's our first time giving it. We've got a lot to learn before we give it at BronyCon, hopefully.
Yeah.
And you want to make sure to improve. If you don't take that as positive feedback, you will not get better faster. You will still get better, but you'll get better faster if you learn from your mistakes. Mm-hmm. And Neil said to always be able to pivot and find some way to adjust. So he was offered a sponsorship from a shop that sells cards, and he said, okay. And so they paid for him to travel around the world and share the brand. So now he was sponsored, and he had branding, and some people may say it's a sellout. But for him, it was an opportunity to use that to take his game to the next level. And then he began to coach others as well.
He's
a sellout, jealous. I know, right? Sponsorships are also hard to come by, and you have to be a good, consistent player. He was writing articles weekly online. So you would have to say, by the end of the week, I have to have a one-page article, and it has to be posted on the website, otherwise I'm not going to get the money. That's still work. And if you build it one more time, he said, just have fun. There's always something you can do every day to enjoy yourself, and whether it's becoming a full-time card game player, or like me, being a corporate citizen. What I do at work, I still think of a reason that I want to be there, and if you don't have a reason that you want to be there, that's when you have to start making a goal and going somewhere you can. And even if you can, you will go home, and right before bed, you can always read a book or play a game. You can make time to have fun, but you also have to make time to not have fun so that you can have money to have more fun later. It's a vicious cycle.
But there's always going to be some part you have to be patient with.
So one suggestion, and you can just build this before. Lists are great for me. We also have another friend of ours who loves lists. I literally carry with me a agenda that has everything for the day and everything for the week and then everything for the month. And then I have a year calendar for all of the conventions because I know I want to go to 6 conventions a year. So I need to have dates, I need to have time off, I need to have the money. And then I need to figure out how many panels I'm doing.
Do you ever think that you might be crazy?
Yes.
You know, of course.
That's what works for me. Some people can keep it in their head.
Yeah.
Some people use computer apps and things like that. But for me, I like to be able to track my stuff through sticky notes and through lists and my agenda that I carry with me everywhere.
It's much easier to keep the fun stuff in your head than not fun stuff. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay.
I know, I make lists for afterwards.
Yay.
This is important.
I love this picture. It's too cute. Okay. So I'm a very positive person. For those of you that have seen me speak before, I like to think about the good. There's always some bad, but if you can build the slide, there's negativity, but it won't help you. And as Neil said, you want to be able to learn from problems. And if there are people that are negative to you, try not to let them affect you. Realize that you have the power to let them influence you. So you can just say, well, I understand that you don't like this or that you say this, but don't internalize it. Don't think that you're bad because someone else doesn't like something you do. Maybe it's them. And if you can, remove toxic people from your life. I know you can't do that, especially with family sometimes.
Yeah.
But try to balance the good and the bad and to understand that you need to be around people that are positive and you need to think good about yourself too. You need to think, I can get to this goal. And if you think I can't, that will not help you to get there because it does take patience and time and you need to think about that goal to get there.
You have a whole panel on the same topic.
Yeah. And okay, build it. There's always something that you can learn. And yeah, you are part of the reason. Whether you do good or bad, there is a part that is you. You can blame other people. You can blame the situation. We could say, oh, well, the slides are a little sideways. It didn't turn out so well just because the projector light was messing up. But is that really why the panel is going the way it is? Like, it's
our fault.
It also has to do with us. So if something goes wrong at some point, think about what you could do better next time. I speak for fun,
yeah.
And I learn from that for fun. So I'm actually entering speaking competitions. I swear I never used to like talking, but as you get practiced in it, it starts to become a way to grow. And I lost in the second to the last round. I was second place. And getting second place is like, oh, are you serious? So close. Was it because the other person was better than me, or was it because I can be better?
I always like to make a joke if someone calls me stupid. It's like, okay, if I'm stupid, that means I can learn more.
Yeah.
I'm smart, and I don't know. I don't learn anything else.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it's always fun. It's always fun. Like, somewhere on the internet, it's like, no. Okay, these are the fun ones. Okay, so I'm a little biased here because I'm Android, but I have other things. A lot of app tools that I use, for instance. Duolingo is just like a language app, but it tricks you into doing it daily. Like, it'll keep your streak. It'll give you XP. They added achievements. Literal achievements.
It's so awesome.
Well, a really fun one, though, is Habitica. What it does is you make an avatar that's an RPG character. And you set down goals and tasks of different varying lengths. And as you do them, you gain XP and level up. But if you don't do them, you get hurt.
No.
Like, you can join a party with people who will keep you accountable. And if you fight a boss and you don't do your goals, the boss is going to hurt everybody. And everyone will know it's you.
No.
Be like, do you need help with something? Or can you do this?
Yeah.
It's neat like that. Keep, if you have an Android, it's literally like a list app that Google has on its own.
And I just use Google Docs on my iPhone.
For iPhone, Tick is one. And then MyFitnessPal, I think that speaks for itself for what it is. It's mm-hmm. also, a lot of these also are websites. They're all also websites, so it's like back and forth either way.
There's lots of apps. And if there isn't one, maybe you can make one and then be rich.
There you go, make money.
Okay, this should be 2 months.
Yeah, oh, there we go.
There it is. Stick to it.
Yeah. It's that some days it's frustrating, but I lose my streak if I don't do it.
Yeah. Achievements.
Yeah, especially for things like that. It's like, oh, this is easy to learn. Other days, like, no, this is terrible to learn. I don't want to do this, but I do it. Yep, speaking of keeping on doing it, practice forever.
I think you can build
the slide. Yeah. I've only said it a few times, too. I did not even attempt that.
We know our slides, guys. Yeah. 10,000 kicks once versus knowing 10,000 kicks. If you practice that one a lot, you can become an expert.
And of course, there's always things that aren't just about, like, I have this end goal, it's getting a physical thing, and I have it. Other things, like martial arts, which I'm doing. Some people are like, I'm going to go back up and I'm done. Other people, they keep going because they want to be there because it keeps them in a goal-completing setting, because the people around you are also black belts and want to keep on building themselves. Not necessarily just for the art, but as people. And I think that might lead to... All right, us.
Yay! Hi!
Hello.
Hi again.
We made a panel.
Yes.
So, what did we do to get here? Flippy has been posting stuff on Facebook. He's like, he's another positive ray of sunshine. So we were just like rays of light if you guys need some smiles in your day. And I said, hey, this is good stuff. And me, as my Brass Knuckles character, I like to do things to help people help themselves. This is a great way to do it. So I said, let's go. I'll take your quotes, we'll make the Google Doc, we'll share everything.
We made a plan and made a list.
So SMART goals, let me go about it. So SMART goals, specific. We're going to make a panel. Measurable, every 2 weeks we'll meet. Mm-hmm. Build that. Achievable, it was very achievable.
We're here, yay.
Yay. Realistic, and then time-based. So very time-based. We copied everything over. We worked on the slides. So we spent, what, 2 meetings just making a document? And then we said, we got to just throw it into slides.
Yeah.
And then it was just like, we just threw everything at it and saw what sticked and then started moving things around. But at some point, you have to make the decision that you've got an idea. When do you move that idea into the physical and start building it? And we did homework. And this is something we did for free, guys. We're not getting paid for this. All we got was this little ribbon. So.
Yeah, I got the ribbon. That's exactly what we're here for. We're done.
Achievement!
We're done.
Yeah. So we wanted to do this, and we took hours out every week to create this for you all.
And some days we didn't want to.
And then we did a little practice.
Yeah.
That was the live. And then.
Profits.
Yes! You got it. Yeah, so that's how we put together the panel.
Okay, admittedly, this does not work for me, but it's a tool you guys can use and it does work for some.
It might work. Some people like to visualize it, either like a mind palace kind of thing where you close your eyes and meditate and see the goal in front of you. Build that. Stay really positive and eliminate any doubts. Think, I am going to do this and I will be there. And then say things that make you feel like you're getting there. One more. I can do it!
You can do it.
The other thing is, on the side there is a wall of all of my badges. So you see I've got a few here. This is not all of the ones that I have. Those are 6-foot long ribbons that I literally just hang on the wall and keep adding to. So instead of saying every con I get these badges and then putting them in a drawer, I hang them on the wall so that I see how much I've gone to, how much I've done. You get to see pictures of the characters. And you do sometimes get achievements, like as a fursuiter, you get the fursuit badge, right? So if you get awards or certificates, instead of filing them away, put them somewhere to remind you of what you have done and that you still can do more.
The big thing is, even fun things have goals and achievements. It's just it's easier to trick yourself to do fun things. Games are really good at tricking you into getting goals done.
That's why you have to be a completionist, right?
And also, speaking of going back to lists, doesn't every just about game have a quest journal?
Yep.
The ones that don't are like, why are you doing this? Alright, okay, this is something I came up with off the top of my head when I was bored at work. So basically, going back to the easiest way to apply this is goals being about plans in a specific environment to grow in. Like, if you're surrounded by toxic people, they won't necessarily be encouraging for what you want to do. Like, going back to martial arts, surrounding myself with people that actually want to keep doing it is important. Otherwise, it's like, what kind of organization is this, you know?
So stay with people that will help you get to your goals.
Basically, try to put yourself in an environment where you want to do it. Like, she wouldn't do this with some random person off the street. She saw that I was already doing something like this, and so she asked me to do it. There's an example.
I might do it with somebody off the street, but I think you're cool.
Okay.
Friendship.
There you go. Oh, this is an example of things. Like, basically, for instance, like, I wanted to get better at art, and on a news website for My Little Pony stuff, whatever. Every summer they have an artist challenge where they give you a prompt every day for 30 days, and then you do it. I did it for drawing the first couple years, and I said one day, like, I've done duct tape art, I'll do it all on duct tape.
And so
every day I did something in duct tape. Even buying out colors that I didn't know I had yet, and like, just cut it out, put it down, there you go. And then I can tell I've got better.
Because you had those achievable goals that were broken into small parts.
And also everyone posted what they did every day. I only did duct tape, but there's like hundreds of people. Some didn't do it every day, gave up, other people went the whole way, and like, oh, I like your art. But they're like, comment on it so you're encouraged in your environment to keep on doing it.
We have,
There's lots of stuff like that in DeviantArt art all the time. If that's something that's key.
Sorry. Also Facebook groups or meetups or Telegram groups. If you have a group of people and you say, once a week we're gonna post, like I'm in a crafty group, so once a week we'll post something that you made, whether it was cookies or sewing, have a way that you share things and that you keep everyone accountable because it's fun and you all continue to do things. If you have a group of people you wanna go to a convention you need to save money for, have a group and say, hey, how much money do you have for the rooms? Have we looked into booking? Have we looked into costumes, travel? There's a lot of things on that list that you'll need. And if you work on it with people that you're going with, you will be able to keep each other accountable and get there.
Yep.
Maybe you can do it.
This is for really big things if you're really motivated. So don't necessarily be scared by it, but do a little bit be scared by it. It's like things that we really want to do that are really big, really ambitious, like for instance, I don't know, like getting into medical school or something. Mm-hmm. A lot of people that's scary, a lot of people that's like, oh, okay, whatever, because they already have a plan and everything. But if you don't have a plan, you know, this is from someone I know, like, because he does coaching for a living. Like when he talks about big goals, he talks about it has to be something that scares you, but you still want to do it.
And it's coaching like Life coaching,
literally.
Not like sports ball.
Not like just, some of them kind of do both. Yeah. You know, some of them are good great like that.
Kind of like a counselor, except that they help you help yourself.
Yeah. Like usually for the really big goals, they make you a little nervous, which is why you're probably hesitant to do them. And usually if you get them done, it's something that makes you grow. Coaches are a tool.
Yeah. So now we've gone to the part that you get to participate. I know we talked to some of you as you came in about things that you would like to do. If you're comfortable in the group setting, we can talk about some of your goals and how we can help you to make them smaller, achievable, measurable, to be able to get to where you want to go. I love this song, Try Everything by Gazelle. And I know we've got our fox in the audience here. So it's true. If you listen to the lyrics, it says, I know I'm going to fail, but I'm still going to try. And that's the truth. You've got to work towards it, and it won't always work out the way you want. But if you do like Neil said, and pivot and adjust and try something new, you can continue to grow. Never stay still. Always keep moving. Because if you stay still, you're not going to get anywhere. You have to have something, even if it's one thing a day. If you do one thing a day, that's 365 things you're going to do in a year. Also, whoa, right? 365 duct tape sculptures.
Yeah.
You know, 365 job applications. If you did one a day, hundreds. But you have to set those small goals to get there.
Language practice.
Did you see this in the dealer's room?
Oh! Yeah, the tigers. It's the dancing tigers and gazelle.
That was fantastic.
So would anyone like to talk about your personal goals? No pressure. Okay.
Well, I actually have a goal in mind working as a voice actor full time, and I actually have a member of a website called voices.com. I have been auditioning regularly for almost 2 years now, and I've actually scored a few jobs in the process, and one of those jobs I've actually got called back for do some additional lines for. In fact, I was actually working on that right before the day I came to Furthermore.
Wow.
What could you do?
Well, you can do anything, really.
Who can you do? Oh, you can do anything.
Yeah, they have lots of different jobs in there.
No, I'm talking the voices you can do.
Oh, I can, well, I don't want to
demonstrate!
Oh, please!
Okay.
You don't have to.
Hi.
You do what, I'll do what. What?
Flash the fastest guy in here. You want something done, he's on. Yeah, no.
Huh?
Your turn.
Oh, he did one?
Yeah, your turn.
Nick Which Wild. One did you do?
Nick Wild.
Oh, you did Nick
I
Wild?
I just did Nick Wild.
Do that again.
Yeah. Flash is the fastest guy in there. You want something done, he's on.
I did not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which one will I do? I'm going to do something everybody knows. Put Mickey Mouse.
In the bathroom.
Oh, maybe I shouldn't do Mickey Mouse. Everything I do is not safe for.
This is a PG panel.
This is a PG
panel. Damn it, I can't say that. I need something I.
Have you
played
Kingdom Hearts?
Hearts?
No. Have you played Kingdom Hearts?
What's that?
Kingdom Hearts, have you played that?
No, I have not.
No.
Give me a line for Mickey Mouse.
The wait for Splash Mountain in six days.
Hey. Got that right there, Mickey. Just did my goofy there.
So it takes practice.
Yep.
Yeah. Do you get coaching?
You can take classes for that. Mm-hmm. And they did actually have like a character panel that I did.
Mm.
They did.
Perfect.
Yep. I can't exactly remember the script, but I remember like going through like five different characters at one time in one script.
And that's a lot of versatility.
Yes.
Do you do your voice exercises to warm up as well?
Yeah. I also do community theater, and we do that as
Perfect. So that's another thing you did to get. There are all these little steps that add up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You're doing practice, conventions, panels, online practice, coaching.
Of course, the key is auditioning every day.
Auditioning.
Resistance.
Because they offer mostly jobs Monday through Friday. They don't offer too many jobs on the weekends.
Mm-hmm. So that means you have to take time to.
Yes.
Wow. Fantastic. Thank you for sharing. Any questions?
No problem.
That's cool. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you.
Did you want to share something?
Nothing that comes to mind, actually.
Okay.
I have an example.
Okay.
So my a lot of my friends, we wanted to do a Ruby cosplay for MAGFest. Some people did most things ahead of time, but the majority of people, no, they didn't. So,
as we mentioned at the beginning.
Literally the 2 weeks leading up to it, the one friend in charge of everything made a list. So there's still a list involved.
Mm-hmm.
There are still steps to put down. Make a weapon for this person, this person, this person, this person. Costume. And we all gathered together in one place in a house that was fit for making cosplay, put ourselves in the environment, and went at it. Like every weekday, and we all had to be out of the house by 12 or 11 because someone got up at 6 a.m. every morning. And we still got everything done. Literally, the Ruby cosplay was done with the 48 hours leading up to MAGFest, including the scythe, and the scythe turned out awesome. But like five people worked on it though. So you do this part, you do this part, you do this part, okay, we're done.
And I think that's true, that you can think you want to get a goal, but it may take longer than you expected. And that's part of the adjusting. So it's good to have buffer time, right? Not doing it at the last minute allows you to have that buffer time. An example for me is, when you apply for a promotion or apply for a job, you need to have your paperwork, but you also want someone to review it. And you should give that reviewer a week to look at it, because they may not have time immediately. And that is, you have to respect that they will prioritize it, they will do it, but you don't want to say, I need this tomorrow, because that's a little rude. So you have to get a buffer time for people to review it, whether it's an application or a paper or. And I think
a recommendation by tomorrow.
Yeah, don't, well, recommendations, yeah, please please warn them and then give them appropriate time. And that takes a lot of scheduling to make sure that you respect that as well. And it's a favor, and you can build on that. So the more that you can build positive relationships by saying, hey, I respect your time, I'd like you to do it the next few days, can we meet? And if you have meetings setting up a time, like we had ours for this the panel, we had it every other Thursday.
Yes.
At 8:30. By having a particular time, we were trying to hold each other accountable.
Mm-hmm.
So that we knew when it would be. So if there was a deadline and someone else is involved, you have to be specific about what and when they need to have something done or when they have to meet. Which is why those group projects are so bad, right?
It's like they don't go over about a set of time to meet up. It's like, oh, just meet me here this day. I'm like, okay, for one day, why?
Yeah.
After Fulgu mentioned the whole cosplay, I did remind me, I do have a similar thing that last year, for not this MAGFest, last MAGFest, about 2 weeks before the convention, I was ready to go. I thought, eh, I'm not going to cosplay, it's fine. And I got a call from a couple of my other friends saying, hey, we're all going as Undertale characters.
Oh.
And
oh.
I'm like, oh, okay, I can do this. I'm thinking, okay, I'll throw something quick together. You know, maybe I'll grab some green spandex and a happy mask face or some little splatter. I decide, and I go down and I got a couple ideas, and my mom's really kind of a crafty woman, artsy, she has fun. And I said, you know, I might need a hand of some of these characters, throw all the rest, picked up, you know, the fully armored Asgore saying, no, we're doing this. Full suit of armor. And I'm thinking, okay, I'll go to the costume shop, I'll buy some kidney armor. And I'm glad I went to her. Because I thought, okay, I got 2 weeks. I'm not going to try and bite off more than I can chew. Mm. And I finished what I wanted to do in about a day. I used some paper craft. I made a bit of a rough armor, painted it gold. I said, no. You have 2 weeks. Look what you did in one day. Raise your standards. Come on, you can do better. You can do better than this. And
wow.
By the end of those 2 weeks, and it was the day before the con, the plaster had dried, the paint was done, the full remodification of the trident, I even had to print it out, I think it was a mercy thing which I impaled on a trident.
Oh,
and everything done, there's a couple of you had seen that thing. It went from just being a couple pieces of paper, like taped to a black sweatshirt and sweatpants, to full done shining gold armor. And everything flowing, I had the horns fully done. And the fact that I had someone saying, no, you can do better. You can hold yourself to a higher standard, you're better than this. And raising and pushing me to try and step it up. And that was really helpful. Sometimes it helps to have someone who, I mean, it was a little hard to have someone say, no, that you know, you're not done yet. And it really sucks having someone after you feel like, okay, I worked hard on this, it's still not good enough. Okay, let's make it better. But I would have never put as much work into it, never felt as great walking around the convention and being stopped every 3 seconds.
Yeah.
I gotta take your picture.
It was a really good Asgore. Really good Asgore.
Yeah.
And the mercy thing was a really nice touch.
That's working with people and adjusting, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Always taking that feedback and not saying that you're bad, but saying that you can do better.
Mm-hmm.
Stay positive.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Again, breaking it down to small steps is like, oh, I have 2 weeks, I guess I can only do this, versus like breaking it down. Sometimes you do need more time than you think, but other times it's like, I actually don't need that much time. Because I can just break it down to this, like, personally, I think everything except just like you're baking something for an hour or going on a car trip can be broken down into like 30-minute segments. If you don't sleep, you have 48 a day. Usually it's less than that. It's like, 48 seems smaller when you say it out loud, to me at least. It's like I can break it down to that. Like again, like doing things like language practice, whatever.
And
be flexible.
Sorry. We can speak just quickly on budgeting. So money is one of those horrible things that everybody needs. How many people spent under their budget here at the shopping upstairs?
Wait, under or
under?
Oh, wait, I never set a budget, so I'm always
okay.
Under it.
Who doesn't have a budget for this weekend? Okay. So I literally go to my wallet and I say, wallet, this is how much money you get. I put $60 in for this weekend. And I also had another pile of money for the hotel. That was a separate pile of money, which I immediately gave to the person that I was staying in. So that money was already spoken for. I always budget that, and I just pretend it doesn't exist. And I was like, hey, I have extra money. Oh, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
Not my money. So budgeting is good because think about if you have a job, how much are you paid per hour? How many hours will it take you to make that back up? Okay? That's $60, that's a lot of money.
Yeah.
And at the same time, you are allowed to treat yourself, but you have to think about what other bills do you have to pay. Between cars, tuition, health care, medicine. I mean, medicine looks So I recommend, if you haven't already, to start keeping track of what your monthly expenses are. It's something that you need to do for the rest of your life. My husband and I have a Google Sheets document that we share, and we always put our expenses in there. But because we've done that for a few years now, we know exactly how much we spend per year, and we know how much we save. We're saving now because we know we can go out to dinner twice a month. We can spend this much money when we're out at dinner. If you can't go out to dinner at all, don't go out to dinner. Buy cheap food. You can get bulk Costco kind of stuff. The membership does pay off. You can have somebody else's card and just go and buy stuff. There are ways that you can save money. And that's not what this panel's about, but it's just to say that budgeting is so crucial, because if you want to get to a convention, if you want to move out, rent is expensive. So you have to say, how much is it going to be? Are there going to be new repairs? Do you need to buy a new bed? There are some things that you don't expect, and you have to have that extra money just in case there's an emergency. Credit cards will only take you so far, and not having debt helps with that.
I do have like $20,000 set aside emergency funds right now.
That's perfect.
It's better than most people.
Yeah, I know. I think they said on average.
So much better than most people.
Yeah. So it's a start, and it's something to build on, and always try and save a little bit more every month. Just like some of the other things we've said, it always try to do a little bit better next time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, whether it's money or a project.
A little bit more. I personally, the way I do it is I have it set up to go into a savings account every month.
Every
week. And it goes out the day my paycheck goes in, so it's like money I never had.
Yeah, and then it's like, I can look at this. Oh, okay, I'm good. Emergency happened, I'm covered.
That's great.
I set aside a quarter of my paycheck for lunch.
Well, I didn't touch my savings account. This is all just other money.
Okay.
And put pretty much all of the rest of it in my savings account, except for $50.
I've also said
$50 set aside to spend during the week.
That's reasonable. That's a list.
It's a list.
Yeah.
Like trading ideas of how you budget. We're perfectly fine with that. We'll do that in the next 10 minutes.
I know, right? Budget stories!
Because everyone can relate to that.
I think that we would never have a convention on BudgetCon.
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 Cancel this year.
That'd be the most amazing con.
Oh, did I tell you how many gold pieces I got? It's like the prizes are staplers, so I'm just budgeting my gold. But yeah, that's. Money is going to be.
You've been showing
those
off all week. You've been showing them off since you got your first one.
I love my gold. I'm a dragon.
By the way.
Yeah, but whether it's for money for our first year, money for our living, money for fun stuff, like Neil spends his money going to play tournaments, or money like I spend my money on vacations. I travel the world when I can. Those all are expensive. Conventions, expensive. So that's kind of like this little pivot at the bottom of all the goal setting. It's like, what can you do to get better, to get more money, to do more fun things? It's unfortunate. If there's a way that you found that you don't need money to do fun things, let me know.
Yeah.
But that's, it's
turn fun things into making money.
Yeah,
there you
turn
go.
Fun
artists.
Things. And fursuit making is, if you practice sewing and get really good at it, maybe.
I don't know how to use a needle.
Just don't stab yourself in the finger with it.
All right, any last comments? Okay, build the slide, please.
Okay.
Pretty sure. Hot
Jonas. And now this one specifically.
Can we replace that with Twilight? I like that one better.
Joe had to
go. Just go for it.
Yeah.
I believe in you.
If you want to have that as your ringtone, go for it.
There you go.
Don't believe in the me that believes in you. Believe in the you that believes in yourself. I love that anime.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, any last questions? 50 minutes with you guys. Thank you for taking time to be with me. Thank you, Flippy, for your first panel. If you haven't gotten a card, I've got cards up here. And if not, thank you for attending. Make some lists and have some fun. Thanks, everybody.
Don't forget what works best for you. That's this important.
It reminds me, I actually made a list.
Hey!
There you go!